670 CHQR, brought to you by CCI Wireless.
Clearly, we're the dollop in your day. 5:41 now here in the morning news. Gord Gillies and Sue Deyell. So we want to find a little bit about you and get to know you as we will over the days and weeks and months ahead.
Oh boy, are you in for a surprise?
Yeah. First of all, you came over from 660.
Mm-hmm. Yep, so, I've been there doing traffic for 5 years or so now.
Yeah, so traffic stuff you've got down.
I've got that down, but it was, you know, me sitting in a little room talking to myself was not very exciting for me, so I'm super excited to be here with you and hanging out.
In Calgary for how many years?
I've been here since 99.
Okay, so yeah.
Long time. Yeah, I love this city. It's now my home for
Where's home? Like, where do you go to visit fam?
Nobody can throw anything at me, right? I'm from Toronto originally.
Oh, okay. Well, yes. No, you know, I think we're beyond that.
Are we
to be
good?
Honest.
Okay, good.
There used to be that, you know, with center of the universe city, thing. Yeah. I think I'm hoping we're beyond that. I never feel the same.
That's
most of the Toronto
people,
I feel. Yeah.
This is my home.
Came out west. You worked with Bruce. Was it Q?
I did. Yeah. I was at Q107 with Bruce for 3 years and we had a blast.
Yeah.
Just
fired for insubordination, was it?
You were something like that. It was his fault. He's not here, so I can blame it on him for sure.
Let's blame it on him. A couple of questions. Family, tell me about it.
Yeah, I have two little kids. I have a son, Luke, who just turned 9, and a daughter, Alexandra, who is 11. And they keep us laughing and keep us hopping every day.
Met them yesterday. Cute kids.
Yeah.
No, not just saying.
And what a joy for you to see them hopped up on sugar, too.
Oh, yeah.
Because Luke had just finished an entire bag of candy floss.
You know, I was trying to remember how bad candy floss is for the mouth. And, did you guys just do the dentist like within the last couple of days?
That's right. Yeah. Yeah. So we'll probably be going back next week now.
We'll have the blue coating, please. Thank you very much.
Exactly.
When we do that. So a couple of great kids. They were having fun. So, and are you a stampede goer? Will you take the kids down and let them go crazy on the rides or do you reel them in?
I work there every night too during stampede.
Okay,
so I'm kind of busy and I'm there till 9 every evening and I don't necessarily want to go down and hang out. But my wife, Bridget, is going to take the kids down and she'll have fun with them and they can do the rides with her and I'll not be part of that.
When you say you work there, who are you with? What group?
I work in the Nutrien Western Event Center.
Okay.
I do a lot of the venue announcing in there.
Oh, neat.
So I get to hang out with the people who really know what they're talking about.
Yeah.
And I do some of the fun and the color along with those guys.
You know what? I think the Stampede should add cattle penning to the things they have on the afternoon rodeo. It's so exciting.
Cattle?
And I know they do that in
it's
that event
It's my favorite
center.
Event
it's
at the Stampede.
Fun.
I love, love, love it.
Yeah.
Yeah, it is. It's great. So I've been doing that for a few years down there and that gets me my fix. And then, of course, I wander out to the Midway and eat things like deep-fried Mars bars just because I feel it's my job to taste those things.
It's the one in Rome, right?
Yeah.
Let's learn a little about this then. If you were to go to Banff for the weekend, an ideal weekend would be Fairmont or camping in Tunnel Mountain.
I do love camping, but there are bears, so I'm going to go with the Fairmont because then I can, you know, pick up the phone and get the things that I need.
Excuse me. That's Royal
right.
Royal Service, there's a bear outside.
Yeah, please
bring
me.
But you guys do that. Do you do real camping? I'm not saying tent trailers.
Not glamping.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's real camping.
You know, we do take our blender and we take our coffee maker and everything with us.
Travel with that coffee maker.
We only
go
to spots where we can plug in. Let's just say that. There must be electricity.
What's fun for you guys? What do you do to get away and cut loose and have fun?
Well, for us, because we have two young kids, a lot of times it's at home. We have people over. Bridget's a great cook, so I let her take care of that.
Nice.
I open the bottle of wine and then I entertain the friends and you know, hanging out is really kind of what we do for the most part.
You posted on Facebook the other day, hey, I'm heading over and there's this big bottle of wine and I'm thinking, oh man, drinker first thing in the morning, this could be either great or it could be fun.
And I'm not seeing a bottle here, like you said, so I'm a bit disappointed, but we'll get over it.
What do you hope to do on this show? What do you want to bring to the morning news?
Well, I just want to have some laughs with you. You and I have known each other for a long time.
Yeah.
And I think that we can have a lot of fun, but do some really smart radio and hopefully, you know, boost the profile of different parts of this city and the things that are going on and the people who live here.
Yeah. And if you've been here 20 years almost now, you know, this is such a unique community. The neat thing about Calgary is, and I'm beginning to see this now, I've said this before over the last few months doing the radio thing, Sue, was that I was worried we were losing a bit of our mojo and just that get up and go attitude. I'm starting to see that pop up again.
I think so
which
too.
Which is super encouraging to me because it has been a long couple or 3 years.
It has been a
real
slog.
struggle.
Yeah, for sure.
But I think, you know, it's looking like we're turning the corner, and maybe it's just Stampede gets everybody into that good, fun, giddy mood.
And that's not a bad thing.
No, of course not.
I think that's one of the good things about Stampede. It really picks up the city, and we realize what a great place we live in.
And the numbers this year, they're already up again, record numbers. They're beating every day from last year. The hotels are filled.
Yeah, bursting at the seams. It's great. Love it.
So one of the Stampede stories today, of course, we'll follow is Aubrey Mottawillo, who was injured in Heat 8 last night in the Chucks. We're going from the Barns tomorrow. Mm-hmm. So we're going to throw you in right away. But, I mean, that's a concern again. I mean, the animal concern, the animal care is huge. And obviously, it's a dangerous sport. It's kind of, you know, I mean, it's four rigs going around the track at high speeds with four horses each. Yeah. So, you know, there are risks involved in this, dangers as well. We'll talk about that. Great to have you on board, though. Welcome.
Thank you very much. I'm super happy to be here.
The good news is she was already getting up really early on her old job.
Just a tad earlier now.
Good to have her on board, and you too. It is a Wednesday. Lots coming up on our show today. Gord Gillies and Sue Deyell. It's coming up to 5:47.